Come on, Till. Hmm? You're slacking. Don't worry about the thorns, you'll be fine. All the stinging nettles, all the spiders, all the snakes.
I'm cutting my dress. It doesn't hurt, don't worry about that.
Okay, I lied, it does hurt. How's it going, guys, and welcome to another explore video. So today me and Tilly have come to explore this pretty cool train tunnel. And from Google Earth it does appear that there are quite a lot of carriages or carts left here. So just gonna have a quick look through here, see if we can get in this way. I don't know, because I couldn't see anything from Google Earth, but okay, so we can't get in this way. We'll have to walk round to go the long way. But as I thought, the whole tunnel was full of carriages and carts, which looks pretty cool. So we'll go and have a little walk around, see if we can find a way in on the other side. Wow. So we've actually made it now to the train carts. Here, literally go as far as you can see. Let's have a little walk through and see what we've got. Most of these would probably have been used for shipping supplies from quarries and yards and things like that. Not sure how long they've been here for. They're quite rusty. I'm guessing quite a while. Looks like we've had a fire on this one. I can still kind of smell it as well, so it must have been fairly recent. Wow, this one looks pretty cool. It's like some kind of crane. God, it's absolutely massive. Looks like one of those machines that they use on the roads when they're resurfacing it. It's quite daunting walking through these, considering how big they are. It makes you feel really, really small. This one's full of sand. Ashford, 1962. Look at the size of the buffers, they're absolutely massive. How badly rotted they are as well. We're coming up to the tunnel now, so we'll have a little walk through there as well. Okay, so we're now going to go into the tunnel. Ooh, some kind of a drain system there. Looks pretty deep as well, to be fair. God, I'm about to fall down there. Shivy around. My God. Looks like some kind of like steel girders that they'd use on building a bridge or something. Bloody hell, they're absolutely massive. That's got to be at least 5 foot, maybe six. It's getting a bit dark in here now, so I'll have to put the light on. Ooh. Temperature drops straight away as soon as you walk in this tunnel. Not sure how long this line's been closed for, but I'm guessing back in the 1700 it would have been a main line from where we've just come from, probably down near to Cheltenham. God, this is really eerie walking through here now. Just hope there's no bloody animals in here. This one's actually got a tree growing out of it. Looks like the sides are bowing out slightly as well. Just have to give way when I walk past it. God, this was massive. These must have been here for years. See the old brakes on them here. Look. All mechanical. 1958 there, look. The further I go, the older they're getting. There's literally nothing left of that one. Almost feels like they're closing in on me as I'm walking through them now. It's like they're getting closer and closer. Look at their light, it's quite spooky walking through here. Ah, oh, we've got another crane here, by the looks of it. How old these are. This is the second crane I've seen here. I normally got a date on them somewhere. I can't see anything. Alright, so I'm almost at the end of the tunnel now. These last few have literally got nothing on them at all. I'm gonna stay at the top. So you can see why I couldn't get in the other side, it's completely fenced up. I'll give you some idea how big this place is. Absolutely huge. Right, I'm going to take a walk back through now. I might walk up on the outside now. So they've got the little refuge spots in here. So if there's ever anyone walking through or working in the tunnel when there's a train coming, these were basically so people could sort of jump aside and let the train pass safely. they're dotted all the way along train tunnels. It's a shame there's no locomotives in there. That would have been quite interesting to come around some of those. But it does appear to be just the carriages with the carts. And the floors look almost like a shine. Look, there's loads of little sparkly stones down there. Not sure what they are. You can still kind of see the dark area on the ceiling where the old steam trains would have gone through. And they've actually discoloured the centre top half of it. That's pretty cool. I will try and find out as much information as I can about this, and I'll put it in the description below. Another refuge spot there. You see the dampness coming through the walls here. Trees growing on this one here. God, look at the rot on that. My God. It's pretty serious. There's a date on that one. 1960. So they do seem to be getting newer as you get out of the tunnel. Oh. Feel the temperature change when you come back outside. Right, we'll have a little walk up to the end and see what we can find up the other side. And then I think we'll make a move. Well, can someone just say it's nice to be back outside again? It's getting pretty cold in that tunnel. I'm gonna take a little walk just on this outside bit here so I can get through. And just see if I've missed anything up the other side. I'll fight my way through the brambles. Oh. Most of this is woodland, it's completely gone. There's no sides or roof to these at all. It's just completely disappeared. See if I can find an earlier date, 1958, which I found in the tunnel. I'm guessing the older ones are probably going to be back in the tunnel. There's another crane out there. Oh, here we go, look, 1954. So that's the earliest one I've found so far. Looks like that was an old liquid container of some sort. Oil, Gulf oil. Yeah, that's written on the side. That's pretty cool. Wow. What's this one we got here? Have you? Yeah. What have you got? 1947. Wow. Now let me just I'll climb under it. Oh God. It's so daunting to climb under these carriages. I know none of them are gonna move, but it's still pretty freaky. Wow. 1947. That is pretty cool. God, look at the size of these boulders on this one. Is that granite? It looks like granite. Wow. We've reached the end of the line on that side. Ooh, steady as you go, Tim. So you can see right up the other end, I don't know if you can see, that is actually still live up there. There's no electrical trains, they're all steam trains that run on this line now.
No, there's electrical as well.
No, we've got diesel as well. Yeah, there's diesel and steam. There's no electrical trains on this line at all. So, I mean, if this had been a live rail, there's no way on earth I would have come down there. But as you can see, they are literally just two rails. It's the third rail you've got to be careful of. Or any overhead power lines, of course. So, I think we'll climb back under here. Just stay on the inside. Oh, look, Till. Looks like a rabbit skull. Either a rabbit or a big, big rat. I'll just leave him back down there. Alright, let's climb under this. Cool. Don't fall down there either, will you? There's another open manhole. I'll have a quick look up here and just see if there's anything more interesting, but I don't think there's going to be honest. I think we've seen the best stuff. Well, we've basically walked almost to the end. And it doesn't look as if they're getting any better, to be honest. We've got about another three carriages and then they stop completely, so I think I might turn back around now and make a move out. Yeah, there's only about another three left out there, so I think we'll call it a day there. Well guys, I hope you enjoyed that little video. Please like and subscribe and we will see you on another explore very soon. Now guys, I hope you enjoyed that little video. Please like and subscribe. It was fucking hell. I thought it was a snake. Oh, I hate fucking snakes.